Today, we're taking another look at songs that sound exactly the same. Copies, illegal. Who's going to jail? Okay, here I have a copy of Juice WRLD's Lucid Dreams versus original Yellow Card, Hollywood Died. Left me falling and
landing inside my grave. I can already hear it's a copy.
I think this is a copy of a Sting song. Yeah.
I can hear the guilt in his voice.
No, that's just a sample, I used.
Yeah, I know.
That's hilarious. Man. Accidents
out on the highway to somewhere. Okay. They tell us about the melodies. There are some similar trends in up and downness, but it's not that close.
I also feel like I've heard other songs with the same accents, like the da 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 da. I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's fine. It's a very basic rhythm. Okay, here we have a copy. One Direction's best song ever versus the original The Who, Baba O'Reilly. I've heard this before. This is the piano, I believe, the piano riff. I think the instrumental is like straight... ripped.
Yeah. They did that with a few rock classics.
It's straight up the same.
Yeah.
Even when the drums come in as well, you're gonna hear in a sec.
Yeah. Yeah.
They switched the chords around a little bit.
Yeah, they did. They go tonic, like in C major C instead of A minor.
Ah.
It's just Jonas. I know you don't.
Yeah, it's like, chords.
Pete Townsend from The Who said, no, I like the single. I like One Direction. The chords I used and the chords they used are the same three chords we've all been using in basic pop music since Buddy Holly. They're not in the same chords, bro. I'm sorry. Ada Cochran and Chuck Berry made it clear that fancy chords don't mean great music. Not always. I'm still writing songs that sound like Baba O'Reilly, or I'm trying to. Okay. I mean, that's a nice sentiment.
Okay, but what do we think, guys? Is this a copy or is it not?
I'd say it's a copy.
Yeah, it's a copy. It's an okay copy, but it's a copy.
Here we have Bad Bunny and Joel and Randy Sapphira and the original Missy Elliott's Get Your Freak On. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I know that riff.
Yeah, I like it.
Wait.
It's the same sample, but sped up.
Is it?
I wonder.
But the melody isn't the same, right?
Yeah, it is. But it was pitched up.
No, it isn't.
Oh, no, it isn't.
It's got an extra note.
They've done a Vanilla Ice one where it's like, hey, they do it like this, but I do it like this.
Dum, 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 dum.
This is almost a sample, but Bad Bunny didn't take the original sound. They copied it. The songwriters on Get Your Freak On received 25% royalty on the song. Okay, well, we were going to say copy anyway, right? By the way, welcome back to another video. My name is Joel from RoomieOfficial. I'm here with Jonas and August. Look at him go.
Oh my God, I'm going.
Oh, I'm going so hard.
Okay, so here we have the copy, Olivia Rodrigo's Deja Vu versus the original Taylor Swift's Cruel Summer. Interesting. Don't act like I didn't teach you Billy Joel. I like that line.
Oh. I like that shot.
Okay, I didn't think that was super close. You know, as far as pop is concerned, we have three notes in one of them and two notes in the other. Olivia Rodrigo has confirmed that she was heavily inspired by Taylor Swift's Cruel Summer while making Deja Vu, as she explains in an episode of Rolling Stone's The Breakdown. I love Cruel Summer. That's one of my favorite songs ever. I love the Yelly vocal
play,
in
please.
It.
Do the voice.
I love Cruel Summer. No, I love the Yelly vocal in it, the harmonized yells she does. I feel like they're super electric and moving, so I wanted to do something like that. yeah, the overall attitude is for sure. And the melody's close, but not that close. The young pop star has now made that moment of inspiration official by adding writing credits for Taylor Swift, Jack Antonoff, and St. Vincent, the three writers credited on Cruel Summer, to Deja Vu.
The production is a bit similar.
I think it's definitely similar. And I mean, after she says that she's heavily inspired, she kind of has to credit it. I don't think it's despicable. I think it's okay.
Copy or not copy, gang?
I'd say copy.
Yeah.
For the purposes of this video, copy, for sure. Here we got copy. Sam Smith and Normani dancing with a stranger versus the original Jordan Vincent's dancing with strangers. So it's the same title. Kinda. Like that 90s vibe.
Yeah.
Where like the music theory doesn't entirely work out. What?
Hello, completely different song.
Yeah, hello.
He said dancing with a stranger.
Okay, so it's just a freaking...
Then it's a copy. It's a copy. They said the same sentence, guys.
Oh my God.
In a complaint filed in federal court in Los Angeles, songwriters Jordan Vincent, Christopher Miranda, and Roscoe Banaloy claim that Smith's Dancing with a Stranger copies essential elements, including the title, chorus, composition, and music video from Vincent's 2017 Dancing with Strangers.
Why are they even bringing in the title into this? I guess they're trying to like add it all together, I guess, but...
There's a song in Swedish Eurovision called Don't Let Me Down, and they said, don't let me down. So the Beatles song Don't Let Me Down has that same melody and that same phrase. In that case, I think it makes sense. But just saying this, like, then Backstreet Boys should sue Justin Bieber for As Long As You Love Me.
I don't know about this, guys.
I think not copy.
Yeah.
So here we have copy, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Down in California, and Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers as the original with Mary Jane's Last Dance.
Oh man, that's many years between.
Love this song. Just putting it out there.
Yeah.
It's good, yeah. I'm not a big fan of his voice, but when the songs really work, it works. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's the same type of like, I'm gonna call it boring rock.
Okay, the vocals are similar as well, yeah.
Yes, yes, yeah. 100%. Yeah. And that was extremely close, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay, so here we have four original, A Little Pitchy and Roomie, Until I Have You.
Singer's great.
Yeah, who copied this?
Yeah, I'm curious now.
I feel like this is too iconic to be copied. It's on Spotify, by the way. It's my song. Link in the description. Check it out. Little Pitchy, Until I Have You on Spotify. I'm real proud of it. I hope you guys stream it. Thank you so much. Here we have a copy. Meghan Trainor's Dear Future Husband versus Olly Murs, which is the original Dance With Me Tonight. Have we done these before? I swear I've compared these before.
Oh, have we? Maybe it's been cut out.
Oh, then. That might be it. Yeah, yeah, okay.
So for the very first time ever, here we go.
Wait, was that Andy Samberg? Come on. No, it's not. What happened to Meghan Trainor? What happened to the bass?
I don't know. I'm too busy grooving, Joel.
Yeah.
Oh,
I didn't, yeah. This is like a... But this is like a blues thing. It just all sounds the same. I don't... It's such a constraining type of song, but they didn't come up with it. Like, Olly Murs wasn't like, yeah, wow, I came up with this amazing thing.
I feel like there's hundreds of songs with this exact rhythm in it.
The production in these two songs is almost identical, and the melody has similar notes. Just the way that was said, it's funny to me.
My C is pretty similar to your C.
Olly Murs hasn't filed any lawsuit, and they even sang a mashup of the songs when they were judges on The Voice UK. Lady.
Tell
This feels so like cheesy and Swedish somehow.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Yeah, like, this is kind of cringe. This clip.
I was definitely not like vibing violently while we were listening to it. No, it was cringe.
I'm gonna put that on not copy just because they've copied just old music. Here we have for copy, Will I Am Scream and Shout featuring Britney Spears, 2012, versus the original Tulisa, I Don't Give a Frick. When you hear this in the club, you're gonna turn the up. This was a pretty cool beat.
I feel threatened by this.
You feel threatened? Yeah, I feel that.
It's like, you're gonna turn this up. It's like, you better.
What?
Wait, what?
Oh.
Is this the real singer?
Ah! Oh, dude, that was a weird sound for me.
Wait. This is the exact same song, or I don't get it.
Tulisa, a well-known British artist, won a legal battle to be credited on Scream and Shout. The song was originally meant to be included on her debut album, and it was going to be titled I Don't Give Up. The producers didn't like Tulisa's version, hence Will I Am and Britney coming in on the track while the producers discredited Tulisa as a songwriter.
Jeez.
Tulisa is now credited and is receiving backdated royalties. This is also why Britney had a British accent on the release track. Wow, that's so bizarre.
That is horrible. Jeez.
This is really like the horror stories that people tell about the music business.
Okay, well, good for her that she got that.
Not technically a copy since it's the same song, but also a copy, you know what I mean?
More just like dirty, dirty behavior.
Here we have Katy Perry's Dark Horse featuring Juicy J, 2013, versus the original Flame, Joyful Noise featuring Lecrae and John Riley from 2008. So that's 5 years in between.
We've talked about this in the lawsuits video. You know what
it is? Oh, yes. I remember this. It's the synth riff.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's talk about it. And it's not even that similar. Your boy's been a Christian quite a few years. Victory in faith, but I failed in my fears. I heard a lot of
words. Let's rage. You were gonna come to me. No.
Nah, this like nothing.
You can't play on that.
He owns quarter notes though, guys.
And also going down.
Nah. This guy's a phony.
The beat is vaguely reminiscent, just like. The group Flame received 2.78 million and songwriting credits. However, in March of 2020, a judge reversed the jury's 2.78 million award and decision. I hope he hadn't spent it.
Yeah, whoa.
Click here for the last video in this series. And today we have 5 for copy, 4 for not copy.
What? That's crazy.
Insane.
Whoa.
Okay, bye.